We've been waiting for a year to unveil this, and it's finally here. So this is going to be a great thing. Seeing the runners run past you and then watching friends and family finish on the big screen in Midtown Plaza.
Thousands of runners will be in Central Indiana for the Carmel Marathon this weekend. Last year's race was canceled because of COVID. Runners from 42 states will be in Carmel for the races. It's shaping up to be one of the top 50 marathons in the country going into 2021. CBS4's Lindsay Eaton shows us the safety changes in place and the new view for spectators.
We're finally at race week after 2 years.
The signs are already posted around the route, giving drivers a heads up about the Carmel Marathon this weekend.
So far, so good. We've gotten everything organized and ready to go for Saturday.
3,000 runners are expected to come out for the 5K, 10K half marathon and the full marathon. Like so many other events last year, these races were canceled due to COVID. Race director Todd Oliver admits planning was a challenge.
It was, you know, quite a few additional steps from all the planning perspective and working with the local government and making sure that our COVID mitigation plan followed the CDC guidelines.
Three of the four races have reduced capacity. Runners must wear masks at the start and finish lines, and even volunteers are keeping their distance.
As opposed to volunteers handing out water, they're only going to put cups on the table and the runners are going to have to pick them up.
Earlier this month, the Indy Mini was canceled, and today the 500 Festival announced the parade was called off too. Oliver knows some runners aren't comfortable with live races just yet, and he gets it.
We've had over 750 people defer from 2021 to 2022. So that also says that just not everybody's ready to get out there yet, and that's okay.
New this year, cameras installed in the light poles will record runners as they cross the finish line. That will be live streamed so spectators can watch it on the big screen in Midtown Plaza. It's a finish line some runners have been working towards for 2 years.
And the finish line will be very emotional for a lot of people, and we're excited to be able to bring that to folks from around the country.
In Carmel, Lindsay Eaton, CBS 4 News.
Lindsay, thank you. And traditionally, the pre-race expo on Friday is held inside. This year, it's outside with half the number of vendors all socially distanced. There will also be hand sanitizer stations throughout the grounds on race day.